Joining us in Hot Copy, attorney Raymond Fortun, lawyer of the California-based Marianne Cayton-Castillo, who owns 501B at Two Serendra, where the explosion happened on Friday. Also with us, Mr. Rene Boy Curado, who is the caretaker of another unit in Two Serendra. Good day to both of you, attorney Fortun and Boy.
Morning, Coco.
Attorney Fortun, let's begin with Boy and tell to describe to us what happened that night. Nakatira ka na dun for about 2 years, diba, sa Serendra. Caretaker ka sa isang unit sa 6th floor.
Apo.
Ano nangyari nung gabing yun?
Abang nanood ako ng TV, bigla na lang may pagsabog, malakas, sobrang lakas, lumanig yung building. Pagkatapos nun, pinatay ko yung TV, lumabas ako ng pintuan. Paglabas ko ng pinto, sumulubong sa akin yung makapal na usok. So, nataranta na ako, parang hindi ako makahinga. Bumalik ako sa loob, tapos lumabas ako doon sa may tiris. Tapos paglabas ko doon, nakita ko yung mga tao sa baba. Dumunga ako tapos nakita ko silang umiiyak tapos nanghihingi ng tulong. Sabi ko wala na sa yatang pag-asa to. Gusto ko nang tumalon eh. Nataranta na kasi ako. Sabi ko parang hindi ko aabutin yung pool doon kasi malapit ay pagdunga mo dyan makikita mo yung swimming pool. Eh.
Okay.
Kaya bumalik na lang ako sa loob tapos dumabas ako ulit doon sa may pinto namin. Tsaka,
mausok pa rin nun?
Mausok pa rin.
Okay.
Paglabas ko, hinanap ko yung fire exit. Nakita ko
paano
kasi.
Paano ka nakahinga? May dala ka ba?
Hindi. Yung suot ko na sando.
Okay.
Ginanon ko na lang.
Okay.
Tapos, lumabas ako doon sa fire exit.
Okay.
Ganun. Bumaba ako sa may hagdanan.
Marami ka ba nakita bumaba rin sa fire exit?
Mag-isa lang ako. Pero narinig ko yung mga tao na humihingi ng tulong. Tulong, sabi ko.
May ilaw pa dun? May hindi pa pinatay yung ilaw, namatay yung ilaw?
Hindi pa. Kasi maliwanag pa yung hagdanan.
May damage ba sa 6th floor?
Hindi ko lang napansin.
Sa unit ninyo, nung umalis ka, wala kang nakita yung damage?
Wala po.
Basta naramdaman mo lang yung pagyanig?
Opo.
Tapos yung mga sigaw ng mga tao?
Opo.
Okay. Pagbaba mo, anong nakita mo dun?
Pagbaba ko doon sa ano, dumiretso ako doon sa may playground. Saka tinignan ko yung sumabog na unit.
Maraming hindi nakakaalam o nakakaintindi kung ano yung sistema ng gas sa Serendra. Kasi LPG siya pero centralized.
Opo.
So 2 years ka na doon. Paki-explain sa atin kung ano yung sistema na yun. Kasi hindi siya tanke, di ba?
Opo. Nasa tubo.
Yes.
Pero 2 years kami doon, hindi kami gumagamit. Bumibili lang kami ng pagkain sa labas.
Pero parang may tubo na lumalabas galing sa wall.
Opo.
Tapos yun ang naka-connect sa cooking range.
Opo.
Pero hindi niya pa nagagamit.
Hindi po.
Okay. Attorney Fortun, you're the lawyer of Marianne Cayton-Castillo. She's the owner of 501 where this incident occurred.
Yes.
How did you get involved in this incident?
No, I only knew about her when I received a telephone call a few minutes after we saw news being flashed on the television that night that there was an explosion.
She is abroad, right?
Yes, she is abroad.
Where is she based?
She's from California.
Okay.
She's from Anaheim.
All right.
She has a very small travel agency there. And, well, I received her phone call that evening itself asking for help.
Within minutes, you said?
Oh, yes. Probably less than 30 minutes after it happened.
Does this happen to you often? You see something break on the news and then you get a call?
Number of times, yeah. Most, a number of times.
And so what did she tell you?
Well, she said she needed help. She needed legal representation, as you can expect. No? Now, when something like that happens, there are always a lot of speculation about the cause of the blast. Always concerns about possible liability to people who were
she
injured.
She thought of that quickly.
Well, I mean, anybody.
It seems to reveal some kind of foresight on her part because I think if that had happened to me or to some other people, you would have just panicked and tried to find, not call a lawyer immediately.
Well, yeah, that's panic in itself. No? Because, well, it's your unit. There were already news flashes of people getting hurt. Already on television, there was already a van that was crushed, and there were already people who were bleeding and dying. So, you know, I mean, anybody who realizes that you might be involved will always say, I need to talk to a lawyer.
Now, what we know is that Angelito San Juan, a friend of that family who moved in for a short period that day, supposedly was complaining earlier in the day about the ventilation system. Mm-hmm. Let me ask Boy here. Nagre-reklamo yung si, ano, si Angelito San Juan. Siya yung sugatan dun sa 501.
Oh.
Na, kasi dumating siya nung araw na yun, nung umaga yata na yun, nung hapon na yun.
And at least came back from lunch and and complained about the heat.
Okay. So parang nagre-reklamo siya tungkol, dahil sa init daw. May naramdaman ka ba nung mga araw na yun na hindi karaniwan sa Serendra?
Anong araw na yun, wala ako dun sa unit namin.
Okay.
Bumalik lang ako dun mga siguro before mag 7 o'clock. Ganon. Yun siya. Tsaka nanood ako ng ano, binuksan ko yung TV sa, nanood ako ng TV Patrol. Ayun.
Buti sinabi mo yun.
Opo, kasi pagkatapos talaga pagbaba ko nung pagka nangyari yung pagsabog, ang naisip ko unang ano, na may sumabog, nakita ko yung unit na warak na warak. Tinix ko si David Oro sa Kasigas. Oh. Yan yung friend ko dito.
Kaya nakausap ka nung gabi yun.
Opo.
Yes. Pero 2 years na ka na, 2 years ka na sa Serendra, may namasdan ka ba na hindi na suspicious dun sa Serendra nung 2 years na yun?
Wala po.
Wala. Parang normal lang siya.
Opo.
Hindi nyo ginagamit yung LPG na yun. Kasi parang yun ang tinututukan ngayon, yung LPG na centralized. Pero hindi nyo pa nagagamit
yun.
Pa pero wala kang narinig na reklamo tungkol dun sa mga, galing sa mga ibang nakatera dun?
Wala, wala.
Wala pa. Okay, so Attorney Fortun. So you get this call. And so you agreed to be her lawyer.
Yes.
What was the next step for you?
Well, no. The reason why they wanted to ask for my representation is naturally to at least already have their side heard before the authorities. No, Marianne was in the States. She was not she's not physically able to at least to give her side of the story. San Juan obviously was incapacitated, and there's a third party here, Herminia Ochoa, who's the who's her aunt as well as a good friend of San Juan.
Some of the early media reports called her Dominique Ochoa, right?
Yes, but actually she's Herminia Ochoa.
All right.
Now,
so let's explain. So, Marianne Cayton-Castillo, based in Anaheim, owns the unit.
Yes.
She lent it or rented it to Angelito San Juan for, is it a 2 week period?
Yeah, she allowed Angelito San Juan to use the unit for 9 days.
Yeah, beginning that day.
Beginning May 31 up to June 9.
Which he did arrive on that day.
Yes.
Meanwhile, she has an aunt, a tita.
Yes.
Herminia Ochoa.
Correct.
Who is based in the Philippines and was assisting Angelito San Juan.
Yes, that's correct.
And in fact, they were supposed to meet for dinner that night.
That's right.
What is her? Have you spoken to her?
Oh yes, okay. Certainly. So in fact, she's given her statement to the Atty police authority.
So her story is that she went there earlier that evening to pick him up, I guess.
Yes, they were supposed to have a dinner reservation at Aubergine Restaurant. That's also in Bonifacio Global City. The reservation was in the name of Angelito San Juan. It was at 7 p.m.
Okay.
So it was actually Angelito San Juan's birthday that day.
May 31. His birthday.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
So she came from her house in Pasig City, went to Serendra just to pick up Angelito.
Did they know each other well? Because she's an aunt of Marianne Cayton. And he's a friend of Marianne Cayton. Were they friends?
Yes, in fact, they were high school classmates.
Okay.
So that's the connection, basically, how Angelito was allowed to use the unit.
So she is the connection between Angelito and Marianne Cayton.
Owner. That's correct.
And Marianne Cayton's relationship to Angelito is less close.
Yes.
Right. But she knows him. She's met him.
Oh, definitely.
Okay.
A high school classmate.
So she was taking him, Herminia Ochoa was taking Angelito San Juan to a birthday dinner.
Yes, that's correct.
Just the two of them.
Just the two of them.
Okay. And so she arrives.
So she arrives at Serendra just a few minutes before 7 p.m. in time to meet that 7 p.m. dinner reservation. And so she asks the lobby guards of Serendra to maybe ring him up so that he can come down for dinner. Lobby guard comes back and says, we called him up thrice, there was nobody answering in the unit. Mm-hmm. So after about 30 minutes, with of course, naturally, Hermino Ochoa kept on calling him by cell phone, and he wasn't picking up the phone as well. So nangulit na siya, sabi niya doon sa lobby guard, you know, sure ako na nandiyan dyan yan, can you check the logs? And so the guards checked the logs, and true enough, Angelito San Juan had not left the building. Mm-hmm. In fact, he arrived at based on the logs at 1:26 p.m. Okay. of that day. And so if you take a look at the timeline, immediately after that, he started complaining about stuffiness inside the room. Anyway, so since they were able to establish...
He filed those complaints with whom?
Oh, with the, he complained to Hermino Ochoa, as well as the management of Serendra. Right.
And the management of Serendra, have you spoken with them?
No.
You haven't spoken with the investigators either?
No.
Right, okay.
Anyway, so what they did next was, since they were sure that Angelito was in the unit, even if he wasn't answering, nakulitan na rin yung lobby guard, sabi nga, okay ma'am, sasamahan ka na lang namin paakyat doon sa unit. So that would probably be around 7:45 p.m. by then. Ochoa knocks on the door several times, rings the doorbell, still no response, until finally, Angelito responds and says, I forgot, I fell asleep, just give me a few minutes.
Jet lag,
most likely.
Oh, okay.
I'm just gonna dress up because I've already taken a shower and I'm coming down.
Right.
So on that note, Ochoa goes down, waits for Angelito in the car. Then the explosion happens at 8 p.m.
Right. Has she seen Angelito since then?
Well, she's been at the hospital daily, taking a look at his condition. The brother of Angelito has also been there taking care of him.
That brother is also from abroad?
Also from abroad, only here for a few months.
Was he was here, he didn't fly here because of this?
No. In fact, he did not even know that Angelito was planing in.
Okay.
The last time that he got a text from Angelito was about several months ago, saying that, you know, I'll see you sometime around first week of June. Mm-hmm. I'll be coming back because I'll be attending a wedding.
Right. So you're saying that you haven't spoken, and Ayala Land hasn't spoken to you, nor have the authorities spoken to you, but you were saying a while ago that Secretary Rojas has actually called Marianne.
Yes, I had been informed by Marianne Cayton that Secretary Rojas called her up sometime yesterday afternoon, but usually they're just the usual questions, finding out who she is, what does she do, some family background as well, probably asking questions about Angelito as well.
So he's very hands-on in this investigation, it seems.
Well, I'd like to look at that as a good thing.
Okay. Boy, so galing din sa mga anong oras kayo ni-round up ng authorities or ng Ayala Land para ilipat kayo sa... Kasi nasa hotel kayo ngayon, di ba?
Apo.
Anong oras nangyari yun?
O
paano kayo minanage yun sa baba? Kasi siyempre magulo pa yun nung nangyari, di ba? Paano kayo...
Hindi, nalaman ko lang na yung mga residente ng Building B na pwede na doon matulog sa Sida Hotel. Mm-hmm. Eh, yun sa isang kaibigan ko.
Is Building B where both of these units are located? Is Building B the same building where the unit is located? That's the same building.
Ang alam ko lang, ano yun, natawag nila District 2, so it must be the second building. Kaya Two Serendra ang tawag.
Okay. So, ano nangyari?
Sinabihan ako ng isang kaibigan ko na doon din nakatira. Sa 306 sila, 306B sila.
Mm.
Sabi niya, pare, pwede tayo matulog doon sa Sida Hotel.
Okay.
Sagot naman ng Ayala.
Mm.
Di, sumama ako sa kanila. Kumuha din ako isang room doon.
Alam niyo ba kung gaano katagal kayo na makaka-stay sa Sede Hotel?
Hindi pa po.
Paano kayo inaalagaan ng Ayala Land?
Ayos naman doon. Libre naman lahat ng pagkain. Hmm. Doon.
May coordination ba sila sa'yo? May desk ba doon para pwede silang lapitan, para malaman ninyo kung ano nangyayari sa Serendra?
Opo, meron doon.
Yung may-ari ng unit, ay hindi nakatira dito sa Manila, di ba?
Apo.
Saan sila naka-base?
Nasa, Visayas sila.
Gaano kadala sila nandito?
Si boss ko yung minsan, mga tatlong beses o apat na beses ang buwan. Eh.
Okay. Alam mo ba kung may coordination na sila sa Ayala Land or sa gobyerno or sa police tungkol sa nangyari sa Serendra?
Wala pa po.
At kayo, ano yung communication ninyo so far with Ayala Land or with building admin or with sa police?
Yan lang. Bumalik ako doon sa, ano, sa Serendra. Gusto ko sanang bumalik doon sa unit at i-check ko kung ship ano ba doon, walang nawala sa mga gamit namin. Tsaka kukuha sana ako ng mga gamit kasi okay. Yung time na yon ang suot ko lang ang ano ko, dala ko, sando saka yung shirt, kaya bumili na nga ako ng damit kasi wala akong magamit.
Oh, pero nakabalik ba kayo, hindi?
Eh, hindi pa kasi nung kahapon pumunta ako doon, hindi ako pinayagan umakyat kasi kailangan pa ang confirmation sa bus ko.
Kasi sabi ng Ayala Land kahapon na yung mga unit owners na gusto bumalik, nakabalik na para kunin siguro yung mga valuables nila. So, ikaw hindi ka pa nakakabalik?
Hindi pa ako nakabalik kasi kailangan pa yung confirmation ng boss ko.
Interesado ba yung boss mo na bumalik ka pa doon or wala namang kailangan kunin doon?
Ang gusto niya na matchi ko lang doon yung unit namin para kung nakasara ba doon or para makita ko kung wala mga gamit doon.
So, nangyari itong blast mga 8:10 ng gabi.
Yeah, diba?
Mga anong oras kayo nung gabing yun ba nakapunta na kayo sa Seda Hotel?
O sa yung gabing yun. Oh. Okay.
Sino nagdala sa inyo doon?
Isang kaibigan ko na nakatira din doon.
May nagsabi
sa akin. No?
So dumiretso ka naman doon.
Apo.
So parang walang representative ng Ayala Land o ng police na nagsabi sa inyo na nandun sa ano. Kasi I'm sure yung mga tao na nagaling sa building, nandun lahat sa baba, di ba? Walang tao ng Ayala Land or ng police or ng local government na nag-organize sa inyo doon.
Nung pagkatapos ng sumabog, yung mga guard doon sa Serendra, inipon muna yung lahat ng nakatira sa Serendra Building B,
okay.
Doon sa may ano sa may veranda lobby.
All right.
Doon tapos habang interview ako sa ano dito sa ABS-7. Pagkatapos noon, nilapitan ako ng kaibigan ko na bike kung gusto mong ano libreng hotel doon sa Seda.
Okay.
Pwede tayo doon. Kaya sumama ako sa kanila.
Okay. We have on the line right now Dr. Carlo Arcilia, is director of the UP National Institute for Geological Sciences. Hello, Dr. Arcilia. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Yeah. Somebody saving time.
Dr. Arcilia? Okay, I think we'll try to reestablish that connection in a little bit. Attorney Fortun, so Marianne Cayton-Castillo is arriving, you said, tomorrow.
Yes, that's what she said.
What's her first order of business when she gets here?
Well, first thing is, of course, to visit Angelito San Juan, no? Just at least to get a heads up on his condition, find out if there's anything else that he or the family might need. Certainly, no, being a close family friend, first thing you do is try to see that everything is okay.
Okay. We're going to take a quick break. Hot Copy will continue after the break. We're going to say goodbye right now to Rene Boy Curado. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. When we come back, we're still going to be with Attorney Raymond Fortun. Hot Copy will continue after the break. Please stay tuned. Welcome back to Hot Copy. With us, Attorney Raymond Fortun, lawyer of the California-based owner of the Two Serendra condo unit where the explosion happened last week. Attorney Fortun,
yes.
Let's return to Marianne Castillo. So she's arriving tomorrow. You expect that the first thing she'll do is she's going to go visit Angelito San Juan.
Yes.
And find out how he is. From what you know, how is he right now?
He is still in serious condition. He cannot be moved out of the ICU, even just for the purpose of cleaning or changing his dressings. The doctors believe no, that any further
movement... It's 85% burns, right?
85% yeah. Burns, 15% third degree.
He's not in a coma.
Not in a coma, once in a while wakes up, but he is under heavy sedation, yes.
Okay. Now, you were telling me that night, he was actually able to walk down.
Yes, that's right. In the account of Herminia Ochoa that she gave to the Taguig probers, no? Immediately after the blast, she saw Angelito San Juan there on the ground floor.
Okay.
Of course, by that time, he looked like heavily burned. Yes. His clothes were in tatters, no? And so, lumabas siya, tinanong niya, ano nangyari sa'yo? And nakapagsalita pa eh.
Okay.
So, meaning, he could listen and he could respond. He said, I touched the door handle and then I heard the explosion. I was thrown to the ground and I felt I was electrocuted.
That's how he described the,
yes,
the incident.
So
do the authorities know this story?
Oh, yes. They got Ochoa's statement already.
Okay. And they got the statement from Ochoa, not from Angelito.
That's himself. Right.
So they haven't spoken to him.
No, they couldn't. They've made attempts to try to get his statement, but the doctors in St. Luke's obviously refused any kind of access to the patient.
Do you want to? I hesitate to use the word speculate, but do you want to kind of recount again what happened and what could have happened to trigger this incident?
And I think only Angelito San Juan would be in a position to tell us exactly what he was doing at the exact moment of the explosion. He's the person who can give a first-hand account. So even the statement that he gave to Ochoa, I touched the door handle and then there was an explosion.
And he used the word I felt electrocuted.
He felt electrocuted, but that could be just simply the blast itself.
Right.
Okay. So, but he touched the door handle. Which door handle was he talking about? Was he in the process of going out of the room? Was he in the process of just closing the door behind him after he'd left the room? Oh, what? We don't know that. What was he doing just immediately, which may have been a reason for the blast?
The other fact here is that there was a recent renovation in that unit.
Yes.
How recently was that completed?
Oh, yeah. Just 3 days, actually, before the incident.
Do you have an idea of how extensive it was?
Yes, I do. I have the plans made, including the diagrams, and I even have photos of the renovations being
made.
Could
you describe that? Because I would suspect the investigators might think it's possible that during the renovation, the gas lines were hit or were affected. And he was the first resident since the renovation.
Yes.
Right? So that could have been the timeline there. How extensive was the renovation?
I'd say it's a moderate kind, although nothing very substantial. Specifically, they just took away one wall and then just made a new partition to divide the unit from being just a single bedroom to a two-bedroom type unit. Now, but with regard to the important part of that renovation, whether the kitchen was in fact involved, no, I saw the plans, the entire kitchen was remained untouched. So as to possible speculation to the possibility that the gas lines may have been affected by the renovation, I think probably highly, highly unlikely, because even the plans themselves would show that the only thing that was moved in that area was really just the removal of the washer-dryer cabinet and then transferring to another part. So the stove itself and the sink was untouched. That entire wall, that panel was untouched.
From the conversation, because you haven't spoken to the authorities.
Yes.
From the conversation that Marianne Cayton-Castillo had with Secretary Rojas yesterday, could she glean, or did she think she was able to glean where the investigation was going, or what kind of conclusion it would reach?
No, at least from what Marianne told me, the questions were very cursory, meaning just more of a background check of who she is, what's she doing in the States, what kind of business they are, well, how is she related to any of the other personalities involved.
Because she said she's going to be filing a statement, I guess, when she arrives.
Yes.
Is she considering, or does she have any legal action to consider?
We're not even looking at that right now. Marian is really just more concerned about Angelito San Juan, the public perception that he is quote-unquote a person of interest, which the family feels is highly, highly prejudicial to him.
I've heard or read you, shall I say, complain about that, about tagging him as a person of interest. What does that really mean? I mean, how does that affect him?
Well, you know, to a technical person, it doesn't really mean much, no? As explained by Secretary Ross, person in interest only means may interest kami sayo,
yes,
because you have something to say.
Yeah.
But for the common man, when you say person of interest, the first thing that pops up is you're a suspect and most likely you're a bomber. So it's highly unfair to him. The family believes he's a victim as well.
Okay, so she is arriving. Marianne Cayton-Castillo is arriving tomorrow. You
yes.
said you've been in constant touch with her throughout since last Friday.
Oh yes.
What's her state of mind?
Highly distraught. You know, just a few minutes after the blast, she gives me a call. No, so she's very, very panicked and very concerned.
What is she concerned about?
Well, you know, it involves her property.
Yes.
Any ordinary individual would be very concerned, would be panicked. Why? Because then your name is going to come up. Then you'd have all of these unfair insinuations of being involved in some terrorist plot. Anybody who is not used to being exposed in a high-profile kind of case would be concerned.
And is she concerned about coming back tomorrow?
Oh, certainly. You know, she has friends saying that maybe you should wait for the outcome of the results, which are being promised to be released by tomorrow before she comes home. And I have been assuring her, look, there is going to be no completeness in that investigation simply for two reasons. One, the authorities don't know the extent of the renovations which were done in that unit prior to the blast. Number two, the testimony of Angelito San Juan hasn't been taken. So the most that probably would be coming out tomorrow would be just, is it a bomb or not? If it wasn't a bomb, then what? But
by tomorrow you mean that the report that the government says is going to release tomorrow.
But as to how that explosion occurred, that's not going to be answered by whatever is there. No? As Mr. Arcilla said, there is no trace of any bomb fragments. There are no cratering. Fine. How about that gas? The problem is that the gas has dissipated. So you don't even know how much gas was actually inside. You need to go and talk to Angelito to find out, were you sniffing gas already just moments before that explosion? What did you do anything in that unit which may have caused the opening or the leakage of the gas? There were breakers inside that unit. I think there has been testimony by the property owners themselves that they have individual gas detectors.
Do you feel that the investigators should have been including you during their inspections of the unit, or did you want to be included there?
I had given my number to whomever, and I've said my number is open. Nobody has called me so far.
Do you think you should have been there?
Have
you wanted to be there? Have you asked to be there?
Well, most that I'd be saying anyway would be secondhand information. So I guess that's why Marianne is coming home. She wants to participate in the investigation. She is very much willing to give whatever documents that they need to try to come up with a more complete picture of the incident.
Okay, we're all waiting for her to come back. Attorney Raymond Fortun, thank you very much for joining us.
You're welcome.
Thanks a lot.